Welcome back to our channel, and thank you all for tuning in and thank you for supporting us. But if you're new to this channel and you haven't subscribed yet, please encourage us by doing so that we can bring you the latest news as they come. And together, we can work with our great leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Eastern Security Network, and IPOB to make our Biafran dream a reality. The terrorist minister of justice, Abubakar Malami, and the criminal former army chief, General Burantai, used the rogue Benin Republic prison warden to poison Igboho in prison. Their plan against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu has failed at the DSS facility because they are afraid of IPOB and Eastern Security Network reaction. Buhari knows that he cannot try that. He knows that. According to reports, Sunday was down with kidney, lung illness in Beninese prison and needs urgent medical care, according to his lawyer, Barrister Aliyu. Barrister Yomi Aliyu, lawyer to Yoruba Nation activist Sunday Igboho, has again pleaded with the Fulani Nigerian government and the government of Benin Republic to immediately release the activist, the freedom fighter, for urgent medical attention overseas. Barrister Aliyu added that the sickness troubling Igboho was not of little measure, and he needs both prayer and medical attention. Barrister Liu said Igboho was not diagnosed with this sickness before he was arrested in Cotonou in Benin Republic. It was so serious that they had to rush him to the hospital. Barrister Liu said that he can't tell if he hasn't returned to prison from the hospital, but Barrister Liu knows that Igboho is battling with ill health, and it seems his kidney and lung are already being affected. A statement by Koike titled, "On behalf of Chief Sunday Igboho," called on the government of Benin Republic to grant Igboho permission to receive urgent medical attention. But the Fulani Nigerian government are threatening the Benin Republic government. The criminal Nigerian DSS has failed on several attempts to poison our great leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu because the international community have warned Buhari to perish their thoughts. And the Fulani Janjaweed are also afraid of the reaction they will receive from Biafran's IPOB and Eastern Security Network. They know that will be the end of the zoo called Nigeria. That will be the end. That will be the end. Barrister Aloy Ejimako, one of the counsel to our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, has lamented that the despicable act of the Nigerian government to frustrate Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's freedom is uncalled for. Barrister Ejimako argued that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu should first gain his freedom from the custody of the criminal DSS before the Fulani Nigerian government could start any negotiation. They can't be negotiating with him while he's in the DSS facility, illegally detained. Barrister Ejimako pointed out that Nelson Mandela of South Africa, Gandhi of India, and Martin Luther King of the United States were released before their government or the government of their countries negotiated with them. When a man is in detention and you wish to negotiate with him, the first step you take is to stop resisting every effort being made to release him from detention. And this is what the Fulani Nigerian government is doing. They want to eat their cake and have it, but it will never work. You know, and that is how they negotiated with Mandela, Gandhi, and Martin Luther King. It is unnatural to negotiate with a man in chains. It's unnatural. But the Fulani Nigerian government, you know, because they behave like animals, they don't understand what they are doing. They think they can use force to keep Nigeria united. They have failed. Biafra is free already. Either the Fulani likes it or not, Biafra is free. Members of the National Assembly from the Southeast Geopolitical Zone said they had started exploring a political solution that would ensure the release of our great leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, from the Fulani Nigerian government's captivity. The leader of the Igbo federal lawmakers in the nation's parliament, Senator Ike Ekweremadu, disclosed this. The senator said on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, let him also assure Ndibo that Southeast caucus in the National Assembly is not resting on its laurels. Senator Ekweremadu said that they are working quietly and surely to address this issue, including finding a political solution to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's matter. Ekweremadu blamed the agitations by various parts of the zoo called Nigeria on a flawed federal system, injustice, poor management of the nation's diversity, and failure of the Fulani Nigerian government to secure lives and properties. They can't do that because they have an agenda and they want to accomplish that agenda. And that is why negotiating with Fulani Janjaweed will not work. Let Biafra go. Let them call for a referendum so that Biafra can go peacefully. Ekweremadu therefore condemned the needless clampdown of freedom fighters when dialogue and giving every part of a country a sense of belonging could have surfaced. You know, they are dialoguing with terrorists and they call them repentant Boko Haram, repentant Fulani bandits. And they are even integrating them into the military. And those are the ones they bring to Biafra land to commit genocide. My brothers and my sisters, the Fulani's time has come. They will perish. They will perish. If they don't go back to Futajanon and Sahel, they will perish. They will perish because Biafra will be free. Thank you, my brothers and my sisters, for watching this video. And bye-bye for now.